Hello everyone, welcome to sansapiri.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn SUMIF function in Excel. The SUMIF function, also known as Excel condition sum, is used to add cells based on a certain condition or criteria. Let's go to open Microsoft Excel file. Before we are going to write SUMIF formula in Excel, we should understand the syntax of a SUMIF function. To illustrate the Excel SUMIF syntax better, let's consider the following example. Suppose you have a list of production, column B, and corresponding amount in column C. You want to know the sum of all amounts relating to a given product, for example, bananas or apples. There are three arguments in SUMIF function formula. The first argument is range. The range of cells to be evaluated by your criteria, for example, B8 to B19 is the range. Because we want to take that range to be a criteria. For the second argument is criteria. The criteria is the condition that must be met. The criteria may be supplied in the form of a number, text, depth, logical expression, a cell or reference, or another Excel function. And the last argument is optional. It is a sum range. The cells to sum if the condition is met. And you need to use it only if you want to sum cells other than defined in the range argument. If the sum range argument is omitted, Excel will sum the same cell to which criteria is applied. So here we have a table that we want to know the total quantity of each product, like for bananas, cherries, apples, lemons. Let's start with the bananas. To write the Excel function or formula, we need to start with equal sign. And then I type SUMIF, parenthesis, and select the range. In this example, the range that we are going to select is B8 to B19, comma. And then we need to enter the criteria. So in this cell, we want to calculate the total quantity of the product for banana. So I put the double quote and type bananas, comma, and then sum range. We want to sum the quantity of banana. So the sum range is from C8 to C19. Close parenthesis and press Enter key to get the result. Now you get the result 700. After that, you can do this for the cherries, apples, and lemon. So SUMIF range, comma, the criteria is cherries, and the sum range is the same as the previous example for the banana, and press Enter keys to get the results. Apple range, criteria, apples, and sum range, the same. For lemon, range, and criteria, lemons, and sum range is here. And press Enter keys. Now you get the total quantity of each product based on the criteria that you want to do a calculation. Let the ball check to make sure the calculation is correct. So let's check the banana. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 records in the product table. So the first one is 340 plus 30, 370, and plus 280 and 650 and plus 50, 700 is correct. If in case we want to add more banana, like 50 more, so the calculation will be automatically change the total quantity. However, by doing so, it is not really flexible. So on the top here, I have a list of product. So I want to use criteria from the reference cell. So in this example, every time the user select the type of product and the calculation of total quantity will show here based on the item that you have selected on the product cell. So let's write the formula SUMIF range, comma. So for the criteria, I'm not going to write down the criteria directly to the formula, but I reference the criteria from another cell of Excel. So the reference is here, the criteria, FH, comma, and sum range, and close parenthesis and press enter. So based on the criteria cherry, so the total quantity is 190, yeah, exactly the same. So let's try to change the product. Let's see how the total quantity will change. Let's select banana. So the total quantity will change based on the item you have selected on the cell product. Thank you for watching. If you want to watch more video series, please subscribe to my YouTube channel.